وبركاته. My name is Lama and inshallah I'll be giving a brief khatira about a hadith Qudsi regarding Awliya Allah. And for those of you who don't know who Awliya Allah are, Awliya is actually plural for Wali. And Wali is being close to someone, being a companion. And so basically Awliya Allah means people that are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Quran mentions them, it says إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا يَحْزَنُونَ. So for the people that are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they experience no sadness and no sorrow simply because they're close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have Allah's protection. And they're the ones يَتَّقُونَ, they're the ones that have taqwa. And to understand what taqwa is, Abu Huraira defines it. A man asked him, what is taqwa? And so Abu Huraira asked him, have you ever gone through a path for say a forest and there were thorns and branches, harmful things in the way? And so the man replied to him and told him yes. And so Abu Huraira asked him, well, how did you go about going through the path? Did you just blindly go through it or were you alert? Did you watch out for things not to harm you? And so the man replied to him and told him, every time I saw a harmful thing, any obstacle, I would maneuver my body away from it so that I wouldn't get hurt. And so Abu Huraira explained to him, that's basically what taqwa is. Taqwa is always being alert, seeing the harmful, the bad, the sin, and moving away from it. And so I'll mention the hadith on the authority of Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, who said that the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, whosoever shows enmity to someone devoted to me, I shall be at war with him. My servant draws not near to me with anything more loved by me than the religious duties I have enjoined upon him. And my servant continues to draw near to me with supererogatory works so that I should love him. When I love him, I am his hearing with which he hears, his seeing with which he sees, his hand with which he strikes, and his foot with which he walks. Were he to ask something of me, I would surely give it to him, and were he to ask me for refuge, I would surely grant him it. I do not hesitate about anything as much as I hesitate about seizing the soul of my faithful servant. He hates death and I hate hurting him. Rawahu al-Bukhari. And so we see that this hadith tells us the status and the distinctive signs of the people that are most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions many points that can help us better understand who Awliya Allah are, their main characteristics, and how they benefit from their special rank from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the beginning of the hadith, Allah mentions that taking a wali as an enemy actually earns the enmity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards yourself. And so this is very important to watch out for. We have to always keep in mind and check how we feel towards others, especially towards Awliya Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as our feelings towards them can be ultimately reciprocated by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards us. Secondly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions that these people come closer to Allah through the mandatory acts of worship in which He loves and has endowed upon us, which are the fara'id. And so these are the five pillars of Islam. And so once we've set these as our foundation, the hadith tells us that in order to even continue to draw closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must also fulfill our voluntary acts of worship, which are our nawafil. And so at this point, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that this person has become a wali and has attained the pleasure and the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and actually commends Jibreel and the rest of the angels to love this person as well. And so with the benefits, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guarantees this person protection. In this hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that He will guide and facilitate every act that this person does, and in order for this person to abstain from the haram. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that He will grant the prayers, the du'a of which whom He loves. Of course, this means that there will be no direct result, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept it as He wills at the right time. I hope that through this quick video and the brief points that I've mentioned, that I've helped shed some light on who Awliya Allah are and how they're so favored and prioritized by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us hidayah, guidance, and taqwa in order to work harder to attain these virtuous characteristics Also, please forgive me for any of my shortcomings. Anything that is incorrect is from myself, and anything that is good is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallah khair.
We once had a teacher of teachers. He changed the world for the better and made us better creatures. Oh Allah.